So the seat buckle in my car has broken. You see the little push button has split. I dropped something heavy on it and it split apart. So I figured this is a good opportunity to try and reverse engineer it, recreate it and 3D print it. So first of all, we're going to scan it on the AutoScan Inspec2. You see it's capturing the data there. And it's quite interesting on the data. We can actually see a lot of detail of that breakage and how it came apart. So it's nice to have a look at that. So anyway, I'm going to load it into SolidWorks and we're going to use QUICKSURFACE in SolidWorks to reverse engineer it. This took some surfacing on the top to get that curve, and lots of extrudes and cross sections on the middle section to get all those intricate holes and clips and details. And we can run a 3D comparison here to see how far the part deviates from the original model. We can see it's pretty close, lots of green on there, and that should fit nicely. The push text on top I've done in Comic Sans just because I couldn't quite find the original font and I thought it was funny. And now we're going to load it into preform so we can slice it for the Formlabs Form 4. We're going to print it in Tough 2000 because this is a very hard wearing material, should last a long time, so the buckle should hopefully last the rest of the lifetime of the car. So load that in, hit print, and there it goes. We'll come back a couple hours later and the part is done. We can see it on the bottom of the build platform here. I'll take it off and wash and cure it, and then once it's done we can compare it to the original part and looks like for like pretty good. So obviously the colour's off, I probably need to get some spray paint and paint it the right colour, but for now we'll test it like this. So I get it installed in my car, put it in place. Of course it's only the buttons, it's not actually controlling the safety element, so I'm not worried about that, but give it a good wiggle and you see obviously secure as it should be, and then push the button and it releases as it should. So I'd say that's a success.